Tamas continues next Saturday evening here on 2 at 8:20. New for Mondays on 2.
Starting from next week, you can get this program on your own special aerial in return for a tiny subscription. Just send in £12,000 in small bills, and we will install this simple device in your backyard.
At 9:45, a spot of improvisation from John Sessions.
This is what happens between television programs to keep you interested. It's called a 1950s interlude. The pot.
At 10:10, Healing Hands, one day in the life of heart surgeon John Walwork.
I perhaps use humour in the same way that other people might use music to relax people.
Three for Monday night on 2. The news over on BBC One now will be followed by the first in a 10-part series of Casualty. Here on BBC Two, in its first showing on BBC television, a rock and roll fantasy thriller directed by Walter Hill in 1984, Streets of Fire. At 10:15 tomorrow evening on 2, Alex Cox introduces another in the season of classic cult movies, the science fiction fantasy THX 1138, directed by George Lucas of later Star Wars fame and starring Robert Duvall and Donald Pleasance, is set in the 25th century, in a world where humans have been reduced to soulless automatons and computers are in charge. Moviedrome is at 10:15 tomorrow on 2.
The heat is on for the next fortnight, and unless you've got a ticket, the only way to watch Wimbledon will be on BBC television. So put your feet up and do it in style.
In half an hour, we've a 40-minute film, Scarf's Follies. This is in place of the scheduled tennis from Eastbourne, which we won't be able to provide because of industrial action. But we can turn our attention to today's cricket and the second test from Lord's between England and Australia. For highlights of the third day's play, we join Richie Benaud.
Saturday of the Cornhill Test match at Lord's. Welcome to the highlights. Great atmosphere here for the third day's play and a vital day for the two teams. Lovely sunshine day and a tremendous crowd in. It's going to be a capacity house once again with the Australians starting off at 276 for six. Steve Waugh is 35. Merv Hughes is 2. They lost Ian Healy late yesterday evening, caught by Russell off Jarvis for 3. 276 for 6, and the situation of the match is that England made 286 and Australia now 10 runs behind. We join play with 9 runs added in the day, 285 for 6. It's the fourth ball of the fourth over, and Dilly is coming in to bowl to Waugh.
Little so often he produces a stroke like that, which is sheer beauty.
What a beautiful shot. Look at this. Watch the foot movement. Goes across. Stays with it. Doesn't pull that front foot away. Perfectly upright when he hits that ball. Exactly how it should be done.